One of the many potential solutions to the Fermi paradox is that the reason we are met with silence, at least so far, in our radio search for extraterrestrial intelligence is that there are other intelligences out there, but they are all listening instead of broadcasting. While there have been some attempts at proactively sending out messages to get the attention of alien civilizations, they have been somewhat half-hearted, and fundamentally, we remain a listener civilization rather than a speaker civilization. This may be the natural state of affairs for most alien civilizations. You could, in principle, build a huge repeating radio beacon. You could make it beam out narrowband signals omnidirectionally to cover the whole galaxy, but you face several problems. To do that, you would need truly titanic amounts of energy, and since there is no guarantee that another civilization would exist at the same time as your own, to hedge your bet, you'd need to maintain your beacon for a very, very long time to increase your chances of success. Think millions of years. And you would do this entirely on a bet that another alien civilization exists out there. Given that the galaxy does not appear to be colonized, and in fact the vast majority of stars appear totally unaltered and natural, would this really be a good bet? Probably not, unless you're simply so advanced that you have no concerns about either time or energy, and you just want to find out if you're alone. That's not impossible, and we should look for beacon signals, but nevertheless, it may simply be too expensive for most civilizations to proactively try to contact other civilizations in a broad manner. But listening for signals is much easier. We do quite a lot of that, and hopefully one day we'll be successful. While civilizations might not beam out a beacon signal for contact, they may beam out all sorts of signals for internal communications, or lasers pushing sail-powered spacecraft, or simply leakage from their equivalent of radio or television. Even radar is a good possibility. In fact, it's one of the better ways that aliens have of detecting us, though they'd need to be pretty close by to see any of that, within about 100 light years, and they'd need a seriously large radio telescope to do it. Unless, of course, they happen to catch the Arecibo message. This truly was a case of the mouse that roared. In 1974, the Arecibo radio telescope was used to send out the famous message you see here. It was aimed at a specific object, the globular star cluster M13. Now, that wasn't exactly the best candidate to send a message towards. Globular clusters are thought to be high radiation environments due to the proximity of all the member stars. That would be a count against intelligent life developing there. Also, it's 21,000 light years away, so we should not expect a response for a while from M13. But if someone does see that signal, they'll probably do a double take. To beam out the signal, they used a trick of sorts. They set the beam to concentrate on a very small area of the sky. The concentrated energy was on level with a 20 trillion watt beacon signal. I'm sure any alien civilizations that might intercept that will see what we did there, but at least for a bit they might think we were a super civilization that commands enormous amounts of energy. But what we did not do was repeat the signal. So chances are, instead of an alien civilization deciphering the signal, they may simply only have seen that it was sent and never repeated, and it might be their equivalent of the wow signal. An anomalous transmission that might have been artificial, but not a good candidate for study because it was a one-off. That may someday change. There is a movement known as METI, or Messaging Extraterrestrial Intelligence, or just active SETI, that seeks to eventually send out a repeating signal to any alien civilizations that might be out there. We've done some of this already in addition to the Arecibo message, but none have a particularly high chance of success. A long-term, coordinated, and planned attempt at METI is for the future, and there is still much debate over whether it is wise to actually send such a signal as opposed to simply staying quiet and listening for others. Personally, I advocate the latter. Let's hear from someone else first, and then make a well-thought-out global decision on whether we want to send an answer. Maybe that's a common viewpoint among all civilizations, and we do indeed live in a universe full of listeners. Thanks for listening. I am science fiction author and futurist John Michael Godier, currently pondering how sad it would be if the solution to the Fermi paradox ends up being alien shyness. And be sure to check out my books at your favorite online book retailer and subscribe to my channel for regular in-depth explorations into the interesting, weird, and unknown aspects of this amazing universe in which we live.